Ryan's here. Hi, Ryan. See people jumping on. Hi, Emily. Hello, Hallie. Second Cup Saturday. So last week on Saturday, I didn't know it was Saturday. I forgot all about Saturday. And a few people actually asked, are you doing Second Cup Saturday? And it was already after time, so I missed it. It didn't feel like a Saturday. Today feels like a Saturday, I guess. So happy Second Cup Saturday, happy ninth day of Christmas, happy New Year, and welcome to my home. If you watched Tipsy Tuesday last week, I did it from my apartment. Because of our restrictions, I can't go out and have a drink. The restrictions are kind of confusing. I've talked about them a few times, but originally, I thought they said restaurants would not be open on the orange days, which means like those are the days that we can kind of go out without having our paperwork. But a lot of restaurants are still open and cafes are open for takeaways. You can go get coffee to go even on like red days. Today's a red day, but you're not supposed to go far from home. I guess you can go for a walk. So I don't know. People go to McDonald's. The McDonald's down the street is open. And then they get food and eat outside, which I don't think you're supposed to do either. I don't know. I don't think anybody really knows what's going on. But I'm drinking coffee at home. This is my Starbucks mug. You can see Starbucks there. We got this on one of our Christmas market trips when we did... We went to Switzerland and Germany and Austria. And so we got a mug in Switzerland. And today I'm drinking, it's an amaretto holiday version for Nespresso. And so it smells really nice. I put a little cinnamon in it and some milk too. I don't usually put milk in coffee. I like black coffee, but with the flavored coffee, I usually add milk because it kind of brings out the flavor. So that's what I'm doing today. So it's not Starbucks coffee, it's Nespresso coffee. Although Starbucks does make Nespresso pods, but it's not, it's an Nespresso branded pod, but it's a Starbucks mug. So that's what I'm having today. Now, what was I gonna talk about? So since I last had Second Cup Saturday, we had Christmas. So I hope you had a great Christmas. It was a nice Christmas here. It's a little weird that we can't go out with our Christmas lockdown, but it hasn't affected us that much. Since we don't have family here, we're not restricted to like where we can go and see people and things like that. So we just stayed home and we went to Mass because Mass is allowed. So that was really nice. I don't know if you saw the pictures I posted, but our Mass was, it was at the one of the traditional Latin Mass churches, and it was all candlelight. So it was really pretty. Candlelight Mass, and it was all sung, like the entire Mass was sung. No homily, which was awesome. I know that, you know, some homilies are really good, but it's really nice when you go to Mass, especially like a Christmas Mass, and they don't do a homily because, you know, what are they going to say? Like, you're there for the birth of Christ. What more can a priest say about that, I guess? So it was nice. It was nice not to have a homily because it didn't really take away from the atmosphere of the Mass. And also, I don't know, I've mentioned this before, I think, but, you know, in Rome, the bishops have recommended we do not receive communion in the hand or on the tongue, only in the hand. They haven't made it like an official rule because the church can't really do that. But at the Latin church, there's no way to get communion in the hand. It's not even an option. And so the older rite, they used to do communion after the Mass. So the Mass goes on as normal. The priest does the consecration. The priest receives communion, and then they clean everything up. They go on with the Mass, but then at the end, they do the final blessing, and instead of leaving, you can come up for communion on the tongue. And I really like that way because, again, you're not like getting up and lining up and going to communion during the Mass, so it kind of keeps the flow of the Mass going. So that was really nice, being able to do that as a family on Christmas. We went to the Christmas Eve Mass. We didn't go out Christmas Day at all. And then we had a couple of orange days this week where we're allowed to go out far from home. And so I made a post about this too. It's on my website, thecatholictraveler.com. I also posted on Instagram and Facebook, but we went to some of my favorite churches. We went to Santa Croce in Jerusalem. I talked about this on the Tipsy Tuesday, but in case you didn't see that, we went to the Scala Santa, went to St. Mary Major. And so it was really nice to get out and get far from home, because that's the farthest we've been in a long time, which is like, I think it's 3 miles away, so it's not that far. But that was really nice. And then we had New Year's. And so New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, those are all red days, meaning we can't leave the house unless it's for an approved reason, like grocery shopping or something. But they also banned fireworks. I think they usually ban fireworks, except for a few official shows. There's one in Piazza del Popolo that I think is based on the one Michelangelo, I don't know if you know this, but Michelangelo designed a fireworks display that they used to do over Castle Sant'Angelo. And now they do something similar, but at Piazza del Popolo. So that's usually allowed. It wasn't this year. But Italians don't care. They like their fireworks. And so around, I guess they started like at 10 o'clock or something, people are just shooting off fireworks. They go to the rooftops and they shoot them off there. People go out in the street, even though they're not supposed to be in the street. The crazy thing is people shoot them from their homes too. And so I think I posted a video of that on Twitter, maybe Instagram too. But an apartment across from us, they had one of those Roman candles, but just on their window. And so the sparks are like flying inside. And you could look down the street and you could see people shooting out fireworks. And it doesn't seem very safe, but it's fun. So I was asleep by, I think, 10:30 on New Year's Eve because it's just another day. But the wife and the kids, they stayed up. And so they woke me up at like 15 minutes until 12. And I came in here and I opened the Prosecco and then had just a little bit. And we, midnight, I went back to sleep. But the fireworks here, sometimes when people are doing, I don't know what they have, like, but it sounds like a bomb and like buildings shake. And it's kind of scary. And so this year, I don't know if you saw, I think yesterday, there was a video posted, I don't know who posted it, but there were all these birds that died because the fireworks went off and scared them and disoriented them and they flew into buildings. And so a street in Rome, Via Cavour, kind of near the train station, there were just hundreds of birds, dead birds on the street. So that was a nice beginning to 2021. It's almost like one of the plagues or something, birds falling out of the sky. But hopefully it'll get better from there. So what else is going on? This week we have, let's see, we have Epiphany. That's next week. And here in Rome, Epiphany is on Epiphany. It's not moved to Sunday. So we will have Mass, what day is that? Wednesday? Yeah, I think it's Wednesday. And then after that, we go back to whatever our pre-Christmas lockdown was. Although Rome, the last several days has gotten a lot of new cases. I'm hoping it's just like maybe a backlog and they're catching up on things. But yesterday there were almost 2,000 new cases just in the Lazio area. And Rome, the whole time, has had very few cases compared to other regions. And right now, it's one of the top regions. So we'll see. We're hoping we go back to yellow or just back to normal. I don't know. I haven't really kept up with the news in regards to that. But I really would like for, of course, I want everything back normal, but I want restaurants to be able to stay open past six. And I don't really care about the curfew. I mean, I don't want a curfew, but if we have to have something, I'm okay with the curfew that we currently have, which is 10 p.m. because I'm in bed by 10. But I really feel bad for the restaurants. So that's what I'm really hopeful for, is that soon that will end. But if the cases keep going up in Rome, maybe we'll be moved to a orange region for a while, and then, well, that won't be good at all. So, what else is going on? It's been raining a lot. The river, the Tiber River, is getting close to the middle of the wall, I guess. That makes sense. The Tiber River used to flood the city, and so they built these big walls along the banks of the Tiber. And now when we have rainy seasons, I think the last big one was in 2014. We had just a couple weeks of rain, and so the water got almost all the way up to the top of the artificial banks of the river. And when we walked by the other day, it was getting pretty high again. But it's just been raining pretty much nonstop for the last couple days, and it's supposed to continue for another week. All done. So what is next Tuesday? I'll be having the Tipsy Tuesday from home again because we'll still be unable to go out. Hopefully next Saturday I can go to a real cafe again. Julie is asking, what is a station church? You probably saw the post I made yesterday. So a lot of people are familiar with the Lenten station churches of Rome. And these are churches where usually something significant happened, like maybe it's a cathedral of Rome, like St. John Lateran, or maybe it's over the site of the tomb of a saint or where a saint lived. And so in Lent, there was this thing. It was started by St. Gregory the Great, Pope St. Gregory the Great, where he would go to a different area of Rome every day during Lent to celebrate Mass with the local community. And so the first church was Santa Sabina, which is on the Aventine Hill. And to this day, the Pope still goes to that Mass for Ash Wednesday. And so the station day for Santa Sabina is Ash Wednesday. But now the Pope only goes to that one. He doesn't do all the rest of them. But the station days continue, and so those churches have their station days. And I'll be talking a lot more about this as we get into Lent, which is already coming up soon. So I mentioned a lot of people know about the station days for Lent, but station days actually go on throughout the year for other significant days. So yesterday was the Solemnity of Mary, Mother of God. And so the station day for that church is Santa Maria in Trastevere. And so it's not as big a deal as it is during Lent, but they do still kind of celebrate a special Mass there on the station day. And a lot of people don't even realize it's a station day. Like, even the people that live in Rome that follow the station churches of Lent, they don't really go to all the churches throughout the year. But like Epiphany, I think, is St. Peter's. St. Stephen's Day is St. Paul Outside the Walls. So like big holidays have a special church attached to them. I saw a couple other questions pop up. Are there breaks in rent due to coronavirus? I don't think so. What we do have is we have a ton of Airbed and breakfasts, like Airbnbs, that have basically gone out of business because they can't obviously there's no tourists coming. And so a lot of them have put up their apartments for kind of a short-term rental period because they're hopeful that this changes eventually. So I guess they're not out of business. They're just temporary out of business. And so you can find a lot of former Airbnbs for cheap, but they're for like 1, 2, or 3 month rentals. As far as like real long-term rentals, like the 3 month lease or something, I don't know that prices have gone down, but I haven't been pricing really. There's a good website though, Immobiliare, spelled with an I, and you can look up all the apartments available in rent for rent in Rome. What else did I see? Is the Pope sick? Any news on the health of the Pope? So there were a lot of rumors that the Pope would step down in 2020. And that's actually a rumor that happens every year, like for the last several years. And it has something to do with what he said not long after he was elected, was that Benedict set the precedent that it's okay to retire. And so he said he might last 5 years. And so after he hit that 5-year mark, everybody was saying, oh, he's going to retire this year. But no, there's nothing like official about that. As far as is he sick, so he had, a sciatica problem. He has a few health issues, like his lung. He only has one lung or half of one lung. I don't know. He has one lung and then maybe half of another from a childhood disease or injury or something like that. But yeah, he had a sciatica problem. And so he didn't do the Vespers for New Year's Eve, and he didn't do the Mass yesterday, but he still did the Angelus. So it's uncommon for him to cancel things like that, but he's not like, it doesn't mean he's dying or anything. He just had a bad back, I guess. Let's see. Podman Dan, I don't know what your actual name is, but yeah, we met at the CNMC in Boston. That was a fun trip. Met a lot of great people there. Father Roderick's thing, the Catholic New Media Conference. That was fun. I used to like those. I went to the one in Boston and also the one in San Antonio. All right, what else do we have here? Other questions coming up? Status of the vaccine here. I don't really know. I'm not following it too closely. But I know in Rome, some people started getting the vaccine around Christmas. So I think they had originally said it would be the beginning of the year. So I guess that's going to start going. Kathy mentions that New Year's Eve, they had to get creative and order from restaurants. Yeah, some restaurants here did that as well. They had like a takeout type thing. And what I really like, some of the restaurants here are doing, some of the more, I guess, fancy-ish restaurants is, because you know, like here you get pasta. I mean, you can get other stuff too, of course. But, if you just went to a restaurant and picked up a box of pasta and brought it home, it might be cold by the time you got home, or it just wouldn't be the same. And so what some of the restaurants here are doing, and maybe they're doing that in America too, I don't know, but let's say you order amatriciana, and they'll give you like a bag of dry pasta, and they give you the sauce in a little paper box, and they'll give you bread on the side, and you kind of make it yourself. So you get home and you cook the pasta, you heat up the sauce, you add the guanciale to the sauce, and you mix everything up. And I like that. I think that's a neat way to do takeout. And like I said, they're probably doing that in America too. But it kind of makes it feel nicer than just like a styrofoam box of cold pasta. But we haven't done that yet here, because my wife just makes all the pasta. Can I repeat the site for rentals? It's Immobiliare. So I'll probably spell it wrong, but Google will fix it. But I think it's Immobiliare, Immobiliare. Again, I probably spelled that wrong. But it should find it. And you can, I think you could switch it to English, but you can look up rentals and even sales, but you can zoom in on certain neighborhoods and you can see all the ones that are listed. Of course, there's a lot that are listed privately, but it's a really good site, and they have an app, which also works really well. And I use it often. I don't have any plans to move here in Rome, but it's just fun to see what's out there and what's available. But it's kind of pathetic looking at the Airbnbs. I mean, pathetic, it's like sad, because there's so many, like even on my street, there's like 20 Airbnb breakfasts, but they're all set up as Airbnbs. So I guess the people that own the apartment, they kind of, maybe they gutted it, they put in, instead of like a real kitchen, they have like a little hot plate, because most people at an Airbnb, they're not gonna be doing a lot of cooking, they don't need a pantry. And so now they're trying to rent them out kind of long-term, but like you wouldn't really want to live there because it's not set up for it. Any ideas in Rome might open up for tourists? I have no idea. Right now, we can't even travel between regions without like a valid reason. So like I can't go to Assisi or Florence or Venice. So no idea when Italy will open up for tourists. Some people that I know here that work in tourism, they're hopeful for the summer. I was actually hopeful for the spring, but I don't know. I don't really know anything. I'm just like, that's me wanting people to come back. Elizabeth asks, how's my business doing during the pandemic? It's not. So for those that don't know, I organize and lead Catholic pilgrimages, thecatholictraveler.com. And so my last group pilgrimage was in February. I had, I think, 15 planned for 2020, and only one happened. And so the rest of them had to be canceled or postponed. Three of them are postponed to 2022. That was for Oberammergau, the German Passion Play that takes place every 10 years. Funnily enough, it was started because they were giving thanks for a pandemic not hitting their town, and they vowed to always do it every 10 years. And then it was a pandemic that postponed it for two additional years. So, and then I also do day pilgrimages, and you can find those on my website as well. And so I think a couple years ago I had 400 day pilgrimages. So they're like 3 hours, they're not a full day. And this year I had a few in January, February, and then I had, I think, two in March before everything stopped. And then after our quarantine, I had one day pilgrimage, and it was a priest friend who was leaving to go back to the States. He was stationed here for 5 years. And he just wanted to see Rome through, I guess, my eyes. But other than that, I haven't had any work. So what I've done is I set up a Patreon page, and so people kind of help me out through there, and I provide some additional content for them. But I really like all the stuff that I create, the videos and the podcast and all that stuff. I like for that to be free, so it's for everyone. So with the Patreon, it's just kind of to support the work that I do, and then also they get a few bonuses. And so that's helped out a ton. I think there's 277 patrons right now. And so they're very generous. So if you're interested, you can find that link on my website as well. But that's how I'm staying going during all of this. Someone gifted you a gourmet carbonara kit. Interesting. I'd like to know what was in that. Christmas tree is awesome. Thank you. My oldest decorated it. And then the rest of us kind of helped, but she was the bossy one with it. Let's see, have I had a chance to talk about Epiphany, how it's celebrated? So do you mean like the markings over the door? So I think they do that in the States too. I know we did it when I was growing up. But you can get a priest to come over and write the year. I can't quite remember. You write the year, and then you write the initials of the three wise men in chalk above the doorways. So that's what a lot of people do in their homes. And they do that in a lot of places here. Like I said, I think in America too. I think that's what you're referring to, I don't know. And sometimes you'll see it in churches as well, like over the front entrance. Did I finally get my IKEA delivery? Yeah, maybe a month ago or so. So that was very nice. What else? Any other questions? Shrimp cocktail iceberg salad for New Year's? Oh, in the microwave. Oh, you had to warm it in the microwave, yeah. We don't have a microwave. Let's see, what did I miss? Loretta says, summer, that made me cry. I don't know what that means, Loretta, sorry. I missed the question when I was talking, I guess. No restrictions on travel. No, Christmas markets. Yeah, we need to do, I think I'm gonna do a Christmas market trip as soon as it's possible. Because Christmas markets are a lot of fun. I talked about that in one of my Tipsy Tuesdays about the possibility of doing that in the future. You have to have a good balance though between Christmas markets and stuff that's not Christmas markets, because you can get over Christmassy market. I don't know. But if you're just looking at markets all day, it gets old eventually. But yeah, I'm definitely gonna do that. Let's see. Eva says they're doing the to-go at her restaurant, pre-cooked. That's good. I really like that idea, that they kind of guide you through cooking the dish. Jerry's asking, does my apartment have a washer and dryer? We have a washer. We don't have a dryer. We use a drying rack, which in the winter takes forever. In the summer, we can put stuff on the roof and it'll dry in like minutes because there's so much sun and the wind. But usually we just keep it inside and it dries pretty quickly. Doreen is a patron. Thank you, Doreen. What else? Kathy says, you can do the chalk thing without a priest. Yeah, I guess you can, can't you? I guess we always had a priest when I was growing up. We had a good friend that was a priest. He would come over and do it. But yeah, I guess the head of the house can do it, or just anybody. Kathleen, you're a patron. You love being one. Thank you, Kathleen. Rome in your home. Mary says that Loretta meant Rome being open to tourists in the summer. That's what she was sad about. That makes sense. Oh, and I see that Loretta wrote that now. Yeah, that is sad. I don't want to go another summer. Lindsay is joining live for once. Hi, Lindsay. Good to see you here. Nelson, you're a patron too. Love the idea of helping me and learning so much. Thank you. I love to show you stuff. Did I get to Santa Maria de Trevi? What was I supposed to? I don't remember. Harmony's asking me a question about a church. I may have forgot what that is. Let's see. Well, we're already at 30 minutes, so. St. Gaps. Oh no, that's right. Yeah, today's feast? No, yes? I don't know. You're right, his body is there. I'll post that picture. I have a picture of it from last year when I was there. Yeah, today's his feast day. I'll post a picture on my website. Any more cooking classes coming up, Eva asks. Yes, as soon as my wife is ready. She says that her carbonara isn't ready yet. The rest of us think it is. But she says it's not. So she keeps practicing. Yeah, soon. And then we're also gonna do cacio e pepe, because that's another really easy traditional Roman dish that's very good. Am I scheduling anything in May, Angie asks. I can, but until we know for sure, I mean, I'm fine putting it on my calendar. I don't make people pay in advance for the day pilgrimages. So we can do that if you want to send me the dates that you're hoping to be here. But like I said, as of right now, there's no date that people will be able to travel to Italy. I would say surely by May, but I said that last year too. And we're still here. Stefano asks, ooh, about the witch. Yeah, we have our witch hanging on the wall over there. So in Italy, there's a witch that delivers presents on Epiphany. And so, yeah, ours doesn't deliver gifts. She just hangs on the wall. I'll get her. Hold on a second. This is her. This is the witch. So this is the Italian custom. They have this little witch lady that brings presents on Epiphany. And so we picked that up in one of the Christmas markets. So just like my mug. So we got this at the Christmas market in Switzerland, and we got that at a Christmas market in Northern Italy. So yeah, there you go. Jade says Jade loves my page. Thanks for sharing everything. Oh, I'm happy to share. Hopefully you can make it back to Rome soon. What else? More walking tours, like when I went to the market. Yes, Megan, I want to do more walking tours as well. The problem the last several weeks with the restrictions and the curfew, it's hard to do that. And also with having to wear masks outside, I mean, that's doable, but it kind of muffles my voice. And so they don't sound very good. I've tried a couple of them. I don't know why. It's like the mic doesn't pick up very good. But as soon as I'm able to do more walking tours, I will be doing that. It's just that, yeah, with the restrictions, it's kind of hard to do. And also, like, there's days where we can go out, like the red days. I could go out for exercise, I can go to church, and I can go grocery shopping. But if I'm walking around with a phone in front of my face, like filming, that might throw up some red flags with the police. And so if you missed when I've talked about this before, we have to carry a form around that says where we live, where we're going, what we're doing, what time we left, and they can check that. And if it's not an approved reason, or if we're not doing what we said on that piece of paper, we can get a fine of up to 1,000 euro. So that's only on the red days though. So the orange days, we have an orange day coming up on the 4th, and then hopefully on the 7th, we go back to yellow. And when we're yellow again, I can do whatever I think. So we'll see. Jerry asks about our New Year's Day meal. Was it a traditional US meal or Italian? So we had black-eyed peas, that's very Southern. Usually we would have collard greens back home, but I don't know if they have collards here. I didn't even look. So we had mashed potatoes, black-eyed peas, and then we had sausages, like German style, and we had sauerkraut. So I don't know what that was from. It sounded like a good idea. So that's what we had. And it was so good that we're gonna have it again tonight. We had black-eyed peas left over. The rest of it we'll make fresh again. Let's see, got the witch in Germany. Yeah, I guess, is it a German thing too? I thought it was Italian, I don't know. Tanya asks, what are the tour guides that are not working do for an income? Some of them, well, the government gives some money. I don't know how that works. They don't give me money because I'm American. But I know that some businesses get money. I think it's like 50% or something. I'm not sure if that applies to tour guides or if that's just other businesses. I know people that work in hotels get that. Some of them that I know that are not Italian, they went back to their home countries just because they're basically, there's no work, so they can't do anything. A few that I know, one being Agnes Crawford, she's Understanding Rome. You can find her website and on social media, Understanding Rome. She started doing Zoom tours. So she basically does them from home. She just kind of makes like a presentation. She goes out and takes pictures, and she's been doing a lot of those. And so that's been really good for her. I've done a few where I just go out and like do a church tour. I do that for my patrons. So some guides are doing kind of getting creative. It's hard for some of them to do on-site stuff just because of the hours and what's open and closed. Like the Colosseum's been closed for a while, so you couldn't do a Colosseum tour or forum. Some of the museums don't have good cell service, but the people are getting creative. I did a museums tour, actually, a few months ago for patrons. Loretta asks, can we wear face shields? I don't see anybody wearing face shields. I see people wearing a face shield in addition to a mask. I don't know if that would be approved. I tried to wear more of like a bandana style mask to St. Peter's a couple weeks ago, and they wouldn't let me in. I had a regular cloth or blown, whatever they're called, the fiberglass style masks. So I was able to put that on. They're a little, I guess they can be stricter than in the US. So they can tell us that we can't wear that and we can't really complain too much about it, especially me since I'm American. Let's see, Cheryl is talking about Christmas markets and nativity. December 4th to the 11th, that'd be good. That would be great for Christmas markets. If you wanted to see Christmas markets now Rome doesn't have Christmas markets, but if you're gonna go up north, Northern Italy, or like Austria, Germany, France, those have really good Christmas markets starting during Advent. So as soon as Advent starts, that's when the markets open. But nativities, if your last day was gonna be the 11th, all the nativities aren't gonna be out because they usually go up around Immaculate Conception. So what is that, the 8th? But they don't all start displaying them on that day. Sometimes they just start building them on that day. So it might be a couple weeks before they're actually up. But you could definitely see a lot of pretty Christmas the weeks leading up to Christmas Day. Am I planning to be in Rome on those dates, December 4th through 11th? Yeah, I should be. Your patrons as well. Thank you. Okay. I'm still scrolling. Lots of questions today. That's good. Do all the restrictions seem to be decreasing the numbers? I don't know. Like when this all started, not like the very beginning, but the second wave, I guess, it did look like the numbers were going down, but I mentioned this at the beginning that Rome in the last week or so has gotten a lot of new cases. And I don't know if they're just doing a lot more testing or if there was a backlog in getting results. But we had 2,000 cases just yesterday, and that's really high for Lazio. So I'm not sure how well they're working. Harmony's asking about Assisi, is everything open? They're under the same restrictions we are. So most likely the restaurants would be open for takeout until orange days, red days. But no, you can't go for indoor dining. Churches are open, things like that. Hotels have no reason to be open, so they're probably not open. they were open. So once this is, once the Christmas lockdown is over, I think Umbria was a yellow region, which means that restaurants can stay open to indoor dining until 6 p.m. What else? Loretta says, Shafiq Shepherd's Field tour was awesome. Yeah, so Shafiq is my Holy Land guide, and the company he is with is Voice of Faith. And so you can find them on YouTube and Facebook and Instagram, but he did a tour of Shepherd's Field right around Christmas Day, and it is really good, so you can search for that there. Okay, anything else? Oh yeah, more questions. Loretta says, they are not allowed to wear the face shield in some places. Scrolling. The new strain showed up in Colorado. Yeah, there was, right after the new strain was announced in the UK, somebody here tested positive for that, and they quarantined them right away. Okay. Is Shafiq Egyptian? No, Shafiq is Nazarene. He's from Israel, but he was born in Nazareth. Or he's born in Jerusalem. His family is from Nazareth. Yeah, he's amazing. So if you ever go on one of my pilgrimages to the Holy Land, that will be our guide, unless he's not available. I usually work around his schedule, though. Is the Amalfi Coast as beautiful in person? Yes, the Amalfi Coast is unbelievably gorgeous. And it's a really fun drive too, but I like it a lot. I don't get there nearly enough. How are my parents doing? My parents are fine. They're just outside of Atlanta. So they're missing us. I haven't seen my parents since February. My wife hasn't seen her parents since November. So that's really hard, but they're all in good health. So that's good. Angie asks, how's the vaccine rollout being handled? I answered that earlier. They were supposed to start at the beginning of the year, but they actually started around Christmas. But I'm not quite sure, like, who gets it, how they get it. Oh, and Shafiq just popped up on Instagram. I was just talking about you, Shafiq. Good morning, Rena. Okay, so some of you are just joining on. Have I led a pilgrimage to Cinque Terre? No, I have not. I've been, but I haven't led a pilgrimage. It's a beautiful place, but I think that if I was going to do a pilgrimage involving a beachy area, I might go somewhere else, just because that one is so popular, especially thanks to Rick Steves. So it's just, it can, especially in the high season, it would be really hard to do a pilgrimage there with a group. But it is really nice, and I do recommend you visit if you can. Would I prefer Tuscany or Umbria for a second home? Umbria, I would. I would love to be in Assisi. I love Tuscany too, though. But I just like Assisi more. Favorite coffee to drink in Rome? Cappuccino. That's all I pretty much ever get. Okay. I'm just answering questions now. So if you have any more, let me know. Otherwise, this has been a very long Second Cup Saturday. Usually they're 30 minutes. This one's already over 45 minutes, which is fine. I'm just over here listening to Christmas music since it's still Christmas. All right, no more questions. Then I'm gonna sign off. So Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and I'll be back for Tipsy Tuesday, probably from this exact same location since we can't be out. And that's it. So. Yeah, that's it. I'll talk to you soon, and good. More questions. Bye. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Epiphany. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas. Good. All right. Thanks for watching. Enjoy your Saturday. Ciao.